Good evening. My name is Annie Beliveau. It's wonderful to be with you today from St. Paul's Chapel at Columbia University. Say you have a resonant space like this one, and you have one voice. How can one voice create a satisfying piece of music? That is the key question I'd like to investigate tonight. I invite you to explore it with me through several sets of medieval Christian chant and original compositions. A lot of the music I'll be singing tonight has no named composer, but I ask you to think like a composer as you listen. What kind of variables were the people who created this music dealing with as they decided how to sing these sacred texts? Throughout the program, here are some things to listen for. When does the melodic line change direction? When does it come to rest? When is one note repeated many times? How many pitches are used? And when does the set of available pitches seem to change? When do patterns repeat? And how do the melodies interact with the resonant space? For all of these elements, when do they meet your expectations? And when do they surprise you? First, I will sing three chant settings of Gloria in Excelsis Deo. I'm going to start with what I would describe as the most repetitive and move to the least repetitive. This is an Ambrosian Gloria. Gloria in Excelsis Deo. Bonae voluntatis. may be the most well-known of the three. This is a Roman Gloria from Plain Chant Mass 9. Knowing that there are many possible approaches to each text, I'm going to present a full Saint's Mass. It's from an English tradition, closest to the second Gloria. This is the Sarum Mass for the Assumption of Mary, which will be sung on August 15th, as recorded in 1532. Notice how changes in vocal range, syllable duration, and repetition affect your experience. For this first movement, the Introit, I invite you to notice repeated patterns. Thank you. this next movement, the Gradual, I invite you to draw your attention to the sets of pitches that are used in different parts of the movement. Justitia. the second Alleluia. I invite you to think about the idea of a resting place and which pitches feel restful. This next movement, the sequence, is the latest addition to the Mass, and it has quite a different style. I invite you to pay attention to the places in the vocal range that this movement goes, and how that affects your experience.
Sama Pia.
appreciate the different syllable lengths. For the communion, I invite you to feel where the resting places are. I spent a year working closely with original manuscripts in England, transcribing pieces including the one you've just heard. This research would not have been possible without the faculty and staff of the Department of Music at Middlebury College, the Middlebury Center for Medieval and Renaissance Studies in Oxford, and Professor Matthew Cheung Salisbury of Oxford University. Studying this music has inspired me to write new pieces for one voice in a resonant space. They play with these same elements of changing direction, available pitch sets, and repetition, and they have some aspects that likely would not have been accepted in medieval practice. The first piece I'm going to sing for you has different pitches available depending on the direction of melodic motion. It's called New Water.
Wait for
sing a piece for you called Unknown Bird on a text by W.S. Merwin. This piece was written for a specific resonance piece. Out of the dry days, through the dusty leaves, far across the valley, those few notes never heard here before, one fluted phrase, floating over, it's a wandering sea. Swells up somewhere else and is gone before it goes on, fallen into its own echo, leaving a hollow through the air that is dry as before. Where is it from? It is not native here. It is not native here. That may be the one thing we are sure of. It came from somewhere else, perhaps alone. So keeps calling for no one who is here, hoping to be heard by another of its own. The last piece I have for you today is new. It's a short piece that I wrote for this occasion on my own text. This is the first performance of Sour Made Sweet. Sweet. satisfying piece? I've tried to answer this question not through words, but through the experience of this music. If you have any questions or comments, I'd love to hear from you on my website, anniebeliveau.com. And I encourage you to explore this yourself in resonant spaces around your home or around your town. A solo voice might be all we have right now, but given a chapel, a staircase, or a parking garage, we can find beauty in it.